Hello guys and welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to talk about how to create and manage libraries into Axure RP. And so if you are interested to it, of course, subscribe to the channel, like and leave a comment if you like. And that's it, let's get started. And so here we are into Axure. So as you can see here, a couple of weeks ago, I created this bloody Axure RP widget library that is actually a small UI kit. We will start from this to create the library. So what I usually do is I use a simple RP file to create all my elements, and after, just after, I create the library. So how to do that? That's really simple. So what you have to do is, first of all, you go on File and you create a new library, okay? New library. Once you click on it, it will open, as you can see, a new file that seems to be the same thing of a simple RP file, but actually it's quite different in the sense that here, this is a file where each page should be one component. Right, so one single component. For example, let's say that we want to start to create this library starting from this UI kit that I already created, right? So the thing is, I just copy the elements. For example, this widget that is just a toggle, I copy and I paste it into the first page, right? And I just rename it, like, for example, this toggle, okay? And actually, that's it. You create a new page and you put, for example, you copy, you paste it here, and you rename it like secondary button, for example, and you take another one, another element, and you create primary button, for example, and you paste it, okay? That's it. Actually, this is the library. Now, the thing is, we have to save this library, okay? We go on File, Save, and we can save it, for example, on desktop, right? As you can see, the extension of this file is not simple RP, but is rplib. It means that is a RP library. We can rename it, like, for example, UIKit. You save it, and we have it here on our desktop. Here we are. As you can see, we have this new file that is rplib, that is not blue as the usual RP file, but is green, as you can see. So now, the thing is, on double click, here we are. Axure asks if we want also to move this library into the main application directory. I can say, okay, keep it here or put it, as I said, in the main directory. If we keep it here, of course, it will stay here, but if I move it, it will move it from here, and here it is. So we go into the Mac, so in the main hard drive, we go into Users, after the name of the users, and after into Documents, and we have Axure Libraries, and here we are. So here is the list of the local library that I have installed on Axure. So that's really simple. So this is how you can basically move the library directly into Axure. If I click on UIKit now, and I say open, it will open again the file that we created before. So you can continue to build your library. The good thing is that now you can see in whatever file you have, that is this a library itself, or it's a new file, that as you can see in the library list, now we have the UIKit. It is the file that we just created. And in fact, we have these three elements that we just created. the toggle, you can drag and drop it, secondary button, or whatever you want, primary button, right? So, and that's it for the library. It's quite simple. So the difference now to say between the normal library and the theme library, of course, as you can imagine, is that the library itself, like this one that I just created, you can of course share it online, but you can only add it yourself. So if you want to create a library that should be created simultaneously with your teammates, the things that you have to do is to go on file, and instead of us creating a new library, you should create a new team library, okay? And it will create a new library, and you have to choose where you have to put basically the project name, of course. So for example, library. You should choose the workspace, so from online, where you want to put your item, for example, in the main folder, and you create the theme project. Once you create this, Axure asks you to save this project locally. Already, as you can see, the library is rpteamlib. So you save it and you open the theme project. And here we are, that now we are inside the same library, but it's a team project. It means that your teammates can directly download this this library and work on the library exactly in the same way as you can work on a team project. It means that you can push pull elements, and that's it. That's it, really, really cool. So I really enjoy to use library because it saves a lot of time. And also, this video is finished. I hope you enjoyed it and you learned something for, new from me. And as usual, if you like this video, please subscribe to the channel and activate the bell, smash the like button, and that's it. And see you in the next video. Bye.